Hey guys, it's your boy Kurt Pearson, and welcome back to my Love Who 16 career. Well, where last time I'm out of the off, I played games against Inter Milan and Arsenal. And this, so I actually have the other North London club, the White Heat of Tottenham Hotspurs. And I also have of Manchester United. Yes, I'm playing, they are. Or my next opposition in the Carling Cup. I played him in the Carling Cup last season as well, didn't I? About this time as well. Odd. But yeah, now let's get into it. And we'll be looking at our three front men because they are on some scoring role. Well, Coutinho is top goal scorer with 8. Next, Correa on 7, and Sturridge has 5 in 3rd. You know, when your highest rated striker is your third best, is 3rd in the fucking scoring rankings, to this guy who's supposed to be supplying him with the goals, you're like, okay, this is gonna be a good season. It's good to see Correa is scoring in goals. It was a lack of goals that led me to drop him last season. It doesn't look like he'll be forcing my hand again this season. But of course, injuries can happen any time. You never know. And I have really good options if something does happen. I have really good options all around. I mean, I have a solid team. I could rotate this team to hell, and I still have a really amazing team. And there's no one on this team I would replace. Peace. I mean, the only reason I would even consider her selling one of my main players is if they asked to leave, and if I didn't have any say in it. As long as I keep winning, we shouldn't have a problem. Varane, however it is said, almost scored what would have been his second of the season. And after that cheeky controversial goal against Sunderland, I've already scored 31 goals. It was actually Spurs who scored the first goal against me in the league last season. It was Kyle Walker. I'll be making sure I keep an eye on him today. He's coming up against him here now. Against him with Royce. Oh no, it's Yedlin. Walker's not even playing. Unless he's over there on the left. I don't think so. I think it's Davis. I'm playing. Interesting choice, Mr. Pochettino. Definitely in an attacking frame of mind. Look at the throw. Very interesting. And the cross is in. He was probably offside, to be honest. There's no way he was onside, right? Or was I misjudging it? Correa making mincemeat of the defense. Oh, Yedlin with the last ditch tackle. And of course that's a foul. Why wouldn't it be? Oh, look at Yedlin stepping in up. Fuck you, prick. Correa, you go to and softly, and career offers to help you up in. You practically told him to go F himself. Screw you.
Thank you very much, Alan.
If I thought I'd get away with it without getting a red card, I'd try to break your legs. Rafael Varane. Dick.
Back defending, and they've cut the pass out there. Maybe that will ease the pressure. That's very good link-up play.
Oh, Pritch card. Hurts. Freaking, the player who's been on loan in the past couple of seasons. He's in real life. I think he's out on loan in real life as well. Or right now. It's not what I was intending to do. But, it's what I did do. It might lead to a goal. Oh, Coutinho. He's not short on confidence, that's for sure. Rain. Henderson. Oh, what a pass to Correa. He's on. Sturridge. He's off. Oh, wow. Fuck me. What? Barely tried to score. I told you to cross it, dude, not try to score. Bell not listening to me against his former club. What a colossal dick. We're all set for the second half. Marco Royce. Past his marker. Well, this attack got a bit of menace to it. Out Sturridge, boom. Daniel Sturridge. He may be he non-existent in real life because he keeps getting feckin' injured, but he's scoring in FIFA, which is all that matters. Nice side volley. Boom! Dyer and Davis and Warmer all stand around and in amazement at Daniel Sturridge's sixth goal of the season. Which is amazing when you consider here he's still in third. Oh, he won't be. Oh, I was gonna say he would equal with Correa there if he'd gotten that. Feel free to play it around Tottenham. You're losing. Yeah, I think they just figured that out. Hang on a second. We don't want this result. Bunch of idiots. Davis knocks it out. Offers well. Took it from his Welsh counterpart, Mr. Bale. Klein was offside. There's confirmation that I'll be playing Manchester United. Is in the calling cup, or Capital One Cup, however you want to call it. Is that going to be a free kick, or is it going to be the corner? Oh, Spurs are going for it. They want to get back into this match. They brought on Harry Kane, the man who succeeded Bale as Spurs' scoring attempt. Laporte! Oh, wow! I don't think Bale's going to get an assist because that hit off the wall. Oh, but wow! I'm not going to lie, I know Bale has good free kicks, so I was actually trying a shot. I didn't get enough power on it to get it over the wall. I blasted it straight into the wall. But Laporte in the right place at the right time to score his first of the season. So both my centre backs have scored a goal in the league. Rain against Sunderland and Laporte against Spurs. It's 2-0. I kind of hope Bell gets an assist for that. I don't think he will because it hit off the wall. Maybe the Spurs player hit off will get the assist. His assist the goal. Very well done. Oh, it was for the other team. Coutinho was offside, so Correa's goal is not going to count. Mason takes the ball off Coutinho before I can make the pass. Oh, that's going to be a throw, thank you very much. Is Bell. Yo, Davis is all over me. What the hell? Nathaniel Klein. Correa! Oh! Get back up! Why didn't you get up faster? Rango. Coutinho! Oh! The defender. Quick to react. He knew. He knew. Coutinho on 8 goals already. There's Sturridge's chance to me. Hit goal number 3. If he can get a cross in. Or he'll pull it back for Henderson. Oh. Jordan Henderson still waiting for his first goal. He scored about 3 at this point last season. Maybe he left his shooting boots with somewhere last season. Oh, but Daniel Sturridge definitely did not. And he buries it to make it 3-0. Oh, and bag his brace. He's his cross was, I think, meant for. It was almost met by Henderson, but the Spurs defender got rid of it. But unfortunately for him, he didn't get rid of it far enough because it only fell to Daniel Sturridge. Was it Davis? I think it was Davis because that's who they were showing. Well, that's who they're pinning it on.
A very comfortable margin for victory. Can't really be any comeback in the time that we've got left.
Daniel Sturridge. He just brace. It's a real tussle. He's where the two of them try and get the ball. Is the is like a sandwich with the Laporte goal as the filling. Tasty 3-0 win. Unless they score here in the last couple of minutes for what would be a consolation goal. Yeah, I know. I didn't think so. Get that out of here. There it is. There's the full Thomas. Oh, or no? Really? It's been pulled back for offside against Harry Kane. Henderson.
Coming up a corner.
Yo, ref, it's 3-0. Oh, what? I'm not gonna. There's not really much left in this match to happen. Yeah, there we go. Full-time whistle is gone. The away fans go home happy. The home fans go home miserable. And it's ended up 3-0. The Daniel Sturridge gets a 9.1. Very nice. City dropped 2 points. Even better. It's so cool because all my title rivals are dropping points before I even get a chance to play them. And I've not yet played City and they've already dropped loads of points. So I'm like, yo, you'll be out of the title race before I even get to play you. It's crazy, man. It's crazy. I think I have seen next month. Yeah, just before I play United. Wow. 2 Manchester clubs in a row. Wow, really? Look at that. All my Premier League games again have been against London clubs this month. QPR, Arsenal, Spurs and West Ham. And I start next month with a London club as well, Chelsea. Friggin' hell. All I'm sure is, I was going to say, what's the name? Palace. I haven't played Palace yet. Probably in December. No? Wait, did Palace get relegated? Huh. I didn't pay much attention. I didn't know they got relegated. Fucking hell. I have to pay more attention at the end of the season to who gets relegated. It was like thinking, oh, where's Palace? It's... Although, I'm in a rush to play them. Of course, in the cups, I don't play my first team. This team will be the team I put out against Manchester United. They are more than capable of performing the job that needs to be done. Manchester United, of course, will not rest their big players. They're going to put out the full team. Hey man, I'm okay with that. I have a team perfectly capable of taking Manchester United to the cleaners and fucking leaving them there. Ashley Young, you definitely need it. I don't know if they sell mouthwash though. I think the only player they're not playing is De Gea. De Gea's moved, didn't he? Oh, so they are playing the first team. I'm cool. I don't care. I really don't. I can beat them with this. This is not even a second team. This would be a first team for any Premier League team. Any Premier League team would be happy to have these boys. I could play all season with this team and still win in almost every single one of those games. That's how much confidence I have in this second team. Especially this boy, Lil Jon Ibe. He who is amazing. Look at him. Oh, he just ruined Damian. That's a penalty. And probably a red card. It's not even a penalty. Ref, are you paying attention? That wasn't a penalty. Well, I think it's clearly... Here we have a Manchester United referee in the house. Typical Manchester United sacking the deck in their favour by getting favours from the referee. I'm cool. If that's what you need to Hooters. To limit how many. Yeah, I beat you. I feel free. Yeah, I'm still going to beat G. Here's a hype. Going to ruin your defense again. Look at that. They have no answer for him. You want to try that again, Damien? Maybe your buddy the ref will let you off with another penalty again. Smashing Ericsson's face. Get a nice corner. But it's short. They won't expect that. Ibe. Ilori. Ooh. Ilori. He had a moment in last season. I'm sure he wouldn't say no to one this season. Especially going against Manchester United. It won't be Glory, Glory Man United. It'll be Lori, Lori Man United. Oh, or it might be Ings. It might be Ings. It is Ings. Danny Ings buries it against Manchester United. It. I like that, you red scumbags. Ings. 1-0. Oh, the much better team is winning. I would think you'd never walk alone, but I'd get copyright strike. So, yeah, I won't do that. I'll just continue to beat Manchester United. The fans will probably start singing at some point. Dear Mans. And, ooh, shot does enough. Have to prevent the goal. And, after Smalling's work, Mata's like, nope. We're going to concede a corner anyway. Hey. Fuck your work, Smalling, you son of a bitch. Players are mutinying against themselves. Navas. Sorry, Neves. I keep saying Navas. Such similar surnames, him and Jesus. Of course, not the same position. And so I don't know why I'm confusing them. Ilori. Moreno. Ings. Origi. Oh, wow. Of course he calls for half time. Because that would definitely have been 2-0. Well, if he didn't. Really good contest this for a place in the quarterfinals of the English League Cup. But still a second half to go. And here it is starting now. Sometimes comes down to who wants it the most. Divock Origi. Riggy. It's a quick break. Oh, I'm back to Origi. 2-0. And it's there for Liverpool. Yeah, that's right, Man United. Stay quiet because you don't got anything of interest to say. Shut up, you little bitches. Yeah, I'm not stupid. I know what the computer was trying to get me to do. Chris Smalling. Sure. Well, now they've won the ball back. Being so close to the touchline. It's like the oldest trick in the book. Well, it's one of the oldest tricks in the book. Not the oldest. They haven't pulled out that rock yet. Tillmans. Whips it in. Really? That was a terrible attempt, Origi. You're not like your first one. Tim Adams, boom! Buries it. 3-0. And he's doing Bale's celebration. And now he's sliding towards the camera. 3-0. Yes. Later.
I have to say it's so one-sided today, but all
credit. Well, I'm busy.
Racking up the goals.
Yes.
Corner count rising. Here's a replay again of the goal. Well, I feel he's thinking if I just get enough power on this, which he did, it's enough to beat the keeper there, and it was in the left-hand side. We'll have a look at that, the corner count. Goes for goal! Good reflexes by the goalkeeper.
Sorry about that. Back to the action. Origi. Kamano. Go on, Kamano. Easy goal for two men. Nope. Hold the defender got in the way. Dickhead. Give it in, Mattia. He couldn't. Even with his pace. Come on, Ings. Come on. He couldn't keep it in. Yo, I'm goal thirsty. Yeah, I want more. I want United to know they were dominated. Cheeky Valdez, he knew Ings was behind him, so he rolled it. Gonna make him regret that decision. And gonna make him regret that decision. What a nice finish from Jordan Ibe. That all came from that roll. Well, 4-0. Enjoying yourself, Wayne. Didn't think so. Joe and I was second goal in the Capital One Cup of the season. Already he scored more than he did all last season. I scored one all last season. Now he's two. This season, at least two in the Capital One Cup. There's still the Champions League. He's not scoring that. And fuck you, Young. I don't care if I get a yelk. Hard. He pushed me first. Yeah, the referee. He obviously saw the push, but he just didn't acknowledge it. He's an idiot. He didn't give the yellow card.
Well, the clock is ticking on. 2 minutes.
He knew it wouldn't have made much difference anyway. Man United are going out whether they have him on their side or not. Although that was definitely a foul. I'm not saying that wasn't a foul. Origi. Let's get a fifth. Come on, let's get a fifth. Cheeky fifth. Should have passed it to Hillemans. And he was just waiting for it. 4-0 will do. 4-0 will do. I've got an 8.7, the best rating of the match. Good for him. Manchester City are through. Chelsea are through. West Ham were beaten by Derby. Interesting. The recently relegated Crystal Palace beat Stoke. And now Wolves beat Oxford United. Swansea and Everton and West Brom and Southampton have both those games have not been played yet. We're at 9 points already. Yo, just give me the title now. Just save yourself. Just save us all some time. And especially when I have Chelsea coming up. So yeah, that's it. That was a very productive episode. But in the next one, I will have games against the Hammers. This is of West Ham. And I think I will have my next game in the Champions League. It should be, CSKA Moscow. Where I recently beat in my Borussia Mönchengladbach career mode. That's a cheeky plug for that. And if I beat them, that will be me officially qualified for the next round of the for the knockout stages, which means the Inter and game and the Celtic game will be simmable. And I've gotten Manchester City in the next round of the Carling Cup, because of course, why wouldn't I? So I'll be knocking out the Manchester clubs in succession. It's a good thing there are no other Manchester clubs of note left in the competition. Although, then again, I don't know where everyone else is. All I know is the winners are from Merseyside, and they don't wear blue, they wear red. Until the next episode, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And I'll see you all.